While you think I'm starting, I may be finishing because God wants to do a quick work here. I'm not talking to somebody here. I do it everywhere I go. Bring out your Bible. Say, this is my Bible. I want to be sure the Bible is your own. Say, this is my Bible. I believe it's the word of God. I am who it says I am. I can do what it says I can. I must have what it says I will. And so bless me, O God. Amen. I'll be reading two scriptures and then we navigate from there, believing God that somebody will have a testimony tonight. Carry your Bible with me to the book of Genesis. Genesis is the beginning of scriptures. Genesis chapter number 15. Genesis chapter number 15. I'll be reading from verse number 13. For the purpose of time, I will just read the most important verses so that I can maximize the time allotted to me. Verse number 13, if you're there, say amen. Amen. And he said unto Abraham, know of a sure. Did you see that in your Bible? Yes. Underline that word for sure. King James says surety. And he said unto Abraham, know of a surety that thy seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and they shall serve them, and they shall afflict them for how many years? You need to talk back to me now. How many years? Please, I'd like you to underline the word for sure. And in case you have an African Bible, the translation is for sure banker. Am I talking to somebody here? All right, you are with me here right now. Verse number 14, and also that nation whom they shall serve will I judge. And afterwards, I like the sound like this. I like the sound. And afterwards shall they come out with what? Great substance. And thou shalt go to thy father in peace. Thou shalt be buried in a good old age. 16, finally, everybody read with me. But in the fourth generation, they shall come out hither again. For the iniquity of the Amorite is not yet full. I'd like you to look at the fulfillment of these very precious words to Abraham in Exodus chapter number 12. And what I discover, I hope you discover it. Exodus chapter number 12. Thank you, Spirit of God. Exodus chapter number 12, verse number 40. I'd like you to please, you have to read this one with me now. Praying that God will grant you the understanding that changed my life. Are you there? Exodus is after Genesis, verse number 40. Because some of you will have to be detailful. You don't come to church too often. Exodus chapter 12, verse number 40. If you are there, say amen. Amen. All right. Can we all read it together? Are you there? Are you there? Want to go, everybody? Now the sojourning of the children of Israel who dwelt in Egypt was how many years? 430 years. But how many years did God said? Talk to me now. How many years did God said? 400 years. How many years did they spend? 430. I'd like you to put your hand in these two scriptures and then I will show you what Paul told Timothy. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse number 18. This is the ultimate where I intend to bring you into. Paul advised to Timothy. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse number 18. Spirit of God, help me here. I'm beginning to feel it. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse number 18. If you're there, say amen. Please read with me if you are functionally literate. Verse 18, want to go, everybody. This charge I commit unto thee, son Timothy, according to the prophecies which went before thee, that thou by them might war a what? A what? A what? A good warfare. Let us pray. Spirit of the living God, I stand like I have always stood Grant me the tongue of the wise and the lips of the prudent, that I may declare the immutability of your counsel. In these few minutes, give us a hearing ear and a believing heart, that by the end of this word, I ask that you grant the desires of our heart and put a testimony in our mouth, in Jesus' precious name. And every living soul say amen. Amen. And every living soul say amen. Amen. And every living soul say amen. Amen. I'd like you to look up here very briefly, because you see, it's going to help you. For some of you, before I finish preaching, God would have actually accomplished what he intended in your life. Somebody say amen. Amen. When God called me specifically, he told me about the dimension of my ministry. And it's important that when I get to a place, particularly for the first time, I laboriously take time to explain what dimension of ministry I operate, so that your faith can be appropriated. I believe that ministry is like it is in medicine. Like in medicine, there are dimensions of field. I didn't study medicine, but to my own classification, I think there is what I call the prescriptive medicine, there is what I call the diagnostic medicine, and there is what I call the curative medicine. And ladies and gentlemen, for the prescriptive, as it is in medicine, I believe our teachers in the body of Christ, who precept by precept open our eyes to see what God expect of us, and then help us get committed and receive that which we so desire. Those in the diagnostic are men with strange insight into people's life, into people's condition, into people's situation, and then they can be able to provide solution. And ladies and gentlemen, the third department, I believe, is the curative. These are men that are endowed with power. These are men that, regardless of what has been prescribed and what has been diagnosed, when you encounter them in a moment, that which is your expectation becomes manifestation. Am I talking to somebody here? And ladies and gentlemen, I may not be in the, you know, the diagnostic ministry. I may not be in the prescriptive. I am in the curative department of heaven. Am I talking to somebody here? Because he said to me when he called me, I will give you access to revelation and I will grant you expression. That at the declaration of the words of my mouth, every expectation shall be turned into manifestation. So it's practically impossible to sit down and hear me preach and remain the same. Because the words in my mouth are not my words. They are carefully orchestrated by heaven. Am I talking to somebody here? For the entrance of his word giveth light and giveth understanding to the simple. He sent forth his word, and the word healeth them, and the word deliver them from their destruction. I prophesy to somebody here under the sound of my voice, by the end of this service, that which is your desire, that which is your expectation, that which you have waited for, that which you have prayed for, that which you have expected, receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Let me hear that amen like a believer. Say, I hear. Sit down, I'm beginning to feel like preaching. So that you are here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, whether you like it or not, you are condemned to miracle. You are implicated. You must have a testimony. I don't care for how long you have waited for it. I don't care for how long you expected it. But one thing is certain. In this few minutes, something will enter your body. Something will enter your life. Something will enter your hands. If your amen is louder, you are the one God sent me to. Say I hear. Say I hear. Permit me to approach this particular scripture we read with a personal testimony of my life. Several years ago, I told God, I'm not going to preach what I have not experienced. I'm not going to preach what I have not thought and felt and then handled. And ladies and gentlemen, this scripture is born out of my experiences. Several years ago, when I entered into ministry, I had an agreement with God. I had a pact with God. Because I came from
from a very, I don't know how to put it, I don't intend to embarrass my parents, but I came from an ignoble background. It was nothing to be proud about. I was born in a family where my mother sell alcohol and my father was her greatest customer. So you can imagine growing up in that kind of a setting. Am I talking to somebody here? I grew up, you know, my parents were always fighting. But I had the desire to truly succeed because I could see my mother doing everything to make us, you know, comfortable to the best of her ability. So when I gave my life to Christ, I got involved in a church and then thank God for that pastor who actually paid my fee through school. So I was reading law and I had in my mind to really be the best, because you see, sometimes when you come from such family you want to really make a difference. But when I got involved in the work of God in school, it became obvious that I needed to preach. The burden was heavy, the desire was strong, that every attempt to think of doing some things that has to do with law, I just don't have that desire. So I said to God, I don't just want to be a preacher, you know, I want to support your work, I want to make some money, help pastors, then build churches. But the Spirit of God was strong in my heart. And I said, Lord, if you want me to preach, you better promise me, I don't want to be a poor preacher. I don't want to be a begging preacher. I want you to be able to bless me and prosper me so that my members can see me as an example. And ladies and gentlemen, that night I had the voice of God so strongly. I will bless you and I will help you. Am I talking to somebody here? It was on that platform I entered ministry. But ladies and gentlemen, when I started church fully in 1999, for 10 good years, I was struggling. For 10 good years, I was suffering. For 10 good years, nothing was working. And you cannot undermine my kind of preaching. I was prayerful. I was a good preacher. I was a caring pastor. I just couldn't understand why things were not working. To make matter worse, I just got married. It would have been easier if I was alone as a bachelor. I could stroll to any member's house and get myself fed. But now you have a wife that has expectations. Am I talking to somebody here? So, Abagosha, ladies and gentlemen, out of the burden in my heart, one of the days I just took a fast and I went to the mountain that was close to a particular place. And then I intended just to be there quietly and pray for some hours. The burden and the weight in my heart, I was in the mountain till daybreak. I was not aware. The night met me on the mountain. And out of much groaning and prayers, I was telling God, but this is not the way we planned it. This is not the way. This is not what you told me. And ladies and gentlemen, I had a voice that changed my entire life. And that was when God opened my eyes. He said, son, you didn't come here with your Bible, but I will give you the word you desire. And that was when I heard in my spirit, Genesis chapter number 15, and God read the scripture to me verbatim in my spirit. He said, I promised Abraham to bring his seed 400 years out, but they spent 430 years, not because I don't want to bring them out, but he said to me, son, you must understand what I call the spirit of delay. God said to me, all that I promise you, I gave them long time, but you have not seen them because you don't know how to pray the right prayer. He said, pray against the spirit of delay, and all that I have given you will appear in your life. Am I talking to somebody here? Ladies and gentlemen, I became so excited, and I was coming from the mountain. I was declaring, no more delay, no more delay. Child of God, hear my testimony. By the time I came down from the mountain, what I didn't see in 10 years, I saw in 1 year. The prosperity I didn't see in 10 years, I saw in 1 year. The church we were struggling to build in 10 years, in 1 year completed. Became the biggest Pentecostal church in Gombe State, Northeast Nigeria. I became so prosperous, ladies and gentlemen, until they began to ascribe my my world to occultism. I said, I like that. Am I talking to somebody here? My prosperity got to a point where I had to invade my community. My father said to me when I bought my first car, I said to him, I've just got in a car. He said, are you sure? I said, yes. He said, are you sure? I said, yes. He said, can you do me the honor of driving the car home? If I die and you don't bury me, you have made me proud. I said, what do you mean by that? He said, I can explain to you just drive that car home. Make sure you drive that particular car. And ladies and gentlemen, to honor my father who had retired from public life and was in the village, I got my driver and I said, we are going home. He said, is there any problem? I said, no, my father wants to see my car. Ladies and gentlemen, I am from Benue State in Nigeria, Middle Belt. By the time I got close to the village, my father called me on phone. He said, son, you aren't entering the village tonight. I said, why? He said, I will explain to you. Don't get suspicious. I asked you to bring the car because we all came from a poor background. Nobody has ever bought a car in 100 years of our family. There is no car that has driven through our community. And I asked you to bring the car because there has been an existing agreement. A man stood up to build a house on the land left for cars. And the elders of the land approached him. Why buildest thou here? He said, they should allow him build. There is no car that has come to the village. So they should not keep a land that a car will not drive through. And they said, no, we aren't going to allow you build. He said, I will build. If any of your children buy a car, I will demolish the house. Am I talking to somebody here? So while I was approaching the village, my father said, the youth are still demolishing the house because your car needs to pass over that particular piece of land. Am I talking to somebody here? Sit down and hear me. So I discovered that my delay was actually the delay of my community. I discovered that my delay was actually the delay of my family. When I drove that car through the village, I couldn't imagine the celebration. I could not imagine the population. They were celebrating a landmark achievement of a car coming into their community in the first 100 years of our clan. Ladies and gentlemen, hear me. I say this to bring you to a point. What he has done for me, he will do for you. I don't know who I am talking to here. If you want to title my message, it is no more delay. I don't care what has been delayed in your life. I don't care what you have expected in your life. I don't care what you have been waiting for. I believe that God brought me here tonight. That delay is broken from your life. That delay is broken from your life. If you are the one I'm talking about, lift up your hand and shout hallelujah. Say, I hear. Sit down, I feel like preaching here. So from the scripture that we read, the Bible speaking said Abraham actually began to grumble about the delay of childbirth. He said to God, will I die childless? God said, no, I will give you a child. Abraham said, I've been hearing about that. How do I know that I will have a child? God said, we don't need to quarrel here. Get me a sacrifice. Build an altar and I will prove to you that you will not die childless. And ladies and gentlemen, when Abraham built that altar, he fell into a trance. And in that trance, in that vision, God began to speak to Abraham, not about a child, but about a family. Not just about a family, but about a community. Not just about a community, but about nationalities. Am I talking to somebody here? He said to Abraham, my plans for you is bigger than just a baby. But this is what I intend to tell you. 400 years from now, your seed will be a nation. And then I will accommodate them in a land that is not theirs. And my plan is to keep them there for just 400 years. And after 400 years, I will bring them out. I am God. The they will come out. Ladies and gentlemen, if you are not surprised, I was. God said 400 years. He was precise. He was specific. He was calculative. And he had numbered the days of their captivity. But ladies and gentlemen, what was meant to be 400 years become 430. What was programmed and intended to be just 400 years became 430 years. My friend, 30 years is not 30 days. 30 years is not 30 months. 30 years is enough to make a boy a man. 30 years is enough to make a girl a mother. 30 extra years outside divine agenda. 30 extra years outside divine plan. 30 extra years after divine program. My friend, the Bible said they were under captivity, even when God had intended that they should be free. Hear me, when God said 400 years, it was not because he lied. God cannot lie. By two immutable ways, it's impossible for God to lie. His words are yea and they are amen. Can I talk to somebody here? So why did God say four and they spent 430? Paul giving us an insight, speaking to Timothy. He said, Timothy, when you hear prophecy, don't just sing about it. When you hear prophecies, don't just dance about it. Prophecies are tools and instruments and weapons of war. According to the prophecy that has gone ahead of you, use them to war. Because when you don't use prophecies to fight, when you don't use prophecies to pray, you become a victim of the spirit of delay. While I was praying for this meeting, God told me personally, there are many of you under the sound of my voice. You are vulnerable. You are a victim of that spirit of delay. If it is not because of the spirit of delay, look at my eyes. I want to talk to you. If it is not because of the spirit of delay, by now, you know where you would have been. If it's not because of the spirit of delay, some of you would have been married long time. If it's not because of the spirit of delay, some of you would have given birth to children and forgotten the pain of labor. If not because of the spirit of delay, for some of you, you have no business being a tenant. If not because of the spirit of delay, some of you know where you would have been by now. Then look at what the spirit of delay has done to you. Mahanda Bakosta Payata. Many of you know that this is not your original level. You know what I'm talking about. Every time you have a discourse with yourself, you tell yourself, I am more than this. That is why I came. That is why I'm preaching. Every delay in your life, every delay in your destiny, every delay in your marriage, every delay in your profession, wherever you are, that delay is broken from your life. Who am I talking to? That delay is broken from your life. That delay is broken from your life. Somebody lift up your hand and shout fire. Shake your body and shout fire. Lift your leg and shout fire. Yeah, 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 yeah. Hey! Lift up your right and say, oh God. Say like a minute. Say, oh God. No more delay. Say it again. Say, oh God. No more delay. If you believe that, give me that amen 3 times. Again. Say, I hear. Slap your neighbor, say, I'm the one he's talking about. Touch another neighbor, say, I'm the one he's talking about. If you believe that, let me hear that amen like a thunder. Sit down, let me finish this gospel. I'm the bruised up eye. Say, no more delay. Do you feel what I'm feeling this evening? Do you feel what I'm sensing this evening? I'm the Brosta Kalibarata. Spirit of God, hear this. Lord, help me here. There is a spirit called the spirit of delay. And if you're not careful, it will incapacitate. It will limit your potentials. It will frustrate your purpose. It will deny deny you your destiny. There are many of you here under the sound of my voice. That is where you are. Are you aware that Israel as a nation of tune and on experiences the spirit of delay? God promised them 400 years and then they spent 430. The journey from Israel or Canaan to Egypt is about just 11 days geographically. But when they came out as a nation, a journey of 11 days became a journey of 40 years. When the spirit of delay is at work, what others achieve in record time, it will take to eternity. What others achieve in 1 year, it can take you 20 years. What your mate achieve in no time, it can take you eternity because of the spirit of delay. When the spirit of delay is at work, your life will be full of motion without movement. Always working and nothing is working. Your life will be full of activities without productivity. You will wake up in the morning and sleep late at night doing several jobs, but by the end of the year there is nothing to show for it. By the end of the day there is nothing to show for it. Hear me, I am a man of God, and if I be a man of God, every spirit of delay in every area of your life, I command that spirit broken from your destiny. I command that spirit broken from your destiny. If your amen is louder, you are the one I'm talking about. Say I hear. Sit down. I feel like preaching here tonight. The spirit of delay is a terrible spirit. The Bible speaking about Daniel. He prayed unto God. And when he prayed, God answered and sent the answers to Daniel. That for 21 days, my friend, the answer was not in heaven. It was not with Daniel. It was somewhere in between by the spirit of belief until Daniel persisted, until Daniel prayed. And then when the answer came through, you know what God told Daniel? He said, from the first day you began to pray, I answered and I sent it. There are many of you here. Hear me. There are stuffs that you have prayed about, expected, dreamt about, that God has released, that they have not entered your life. Do you know my assignment in this church? I did not only come as a preacher. I came as a prophetic preacher. I did not just come as a prophetic preacher. I feel I am a spiritual clearing and forwarding agent. Am I talking to somebody here? Jesus. Whatever you have imported from heaven that has not entered your life, if I be a man of God, I clear them and I forward them to your life. I clear them and I forward them to your life. I clear them and I forward them to your life. If your amen is louder, receive them now. If your amen is louder, receive them now. If you are the one, receive them now. Lift up your hand and shout hallelujah. Touch your neighbor, say, I'm the one he's talking about. Say, I hear. Sit down, let me finish this gospel. Lord, help me here. I'm behind her. Are you aware that, ladies and gentlemen, by the timing of God, by the program of God, by the arrangement of God, some of you are behind schedule? The Bible speaking said, God told them 400 years. And listen, God is God. Circumstances does not change who he is. Condition does not change who he is. So when he said 400 years, hear this. Before God, they were free. But in reality, they were still slaves. Before God, they were multimillionaires. Because you know what he told Abraham? He said that the 400 years, I will bring them out. And they will not come out empty. They are coming out loaded. They are coming out rich. They are coming out super rich. So at the 400 years, before God, they were rich men. But in reality, they were poor men. Are you aware that when the spirit of delay is at work, heaven's impression of your person will be different from your reality in life? There are many of you here. You are a direct opposite of what heaven has concluded, planned, and arranged for your life. God had programmed that you are a blessed and prosperous man. That is who you are. But in reality, you are still begging for bread. You are still doing hand to mouth. There are many of you here. Before God, you are married. As far as God is concerned, you are a married person. You have finished giving back to children. But because of the spirit of delay, in reality, husband is still a prayer point. Children are still on their way, and you are comforting yourself with a song. My miracle is on the way. How long will it be on the way? Can I talk to somebody here? I intend tonight to bring you to a place of spiritual annoyance, so that when you stand up to pray, you will look at yourself and exit from this position. You will tell yourself and tell the devil, I am more than this. You will tell yourself and tell the devil, God's plan and program for me is more than this. Can I talk to somebody here? There are many of you. You think you are a bachelor. You are not a bachelor. By God's arrangement, you should have been married long time ago. But can't you see that time has passed? You are not a bachelor. You are a manchelor. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to anybody here? That devil is a liar. Look at me. Every time God wants to break delay, he brings a man. I don't care whether you know my name. I don't care whether you like my face. But I have an assignment tonight. The Bible said by a prophet, the Lord brought Israel out of Egypt. And by a prophet, he preserved them. I have one assignment in this meeting. And if that assignment is not completed, I consider my coming a failure. I consider the resources here a waste. You got to move from where you are to where God wants you to be. You got to move from where you are into the promises of God. The Bible speaking said, believe the Lord your God, thou shalt be established. But believe his prophet, and you shall. You got to believe me here tonight. I will separate. You just have to agree with me. You don't have a choice. You may not like my English. I may not appear like a regular pastor. But I have an assignment. And hear me. Wherever the devil has kept you limited by delay, is broken from your life. It's broken from your life. It's broken from your life. Give me that amen 3 times. Again. Again. Slap your neighbor, say no more delay. Look at another neighbor, say no more delay. Touch another neighbor, say no more delay. Say, I hear. Sit down, let me conclude. When God wanted to break delay in the life of Abraham, he brought 3 men to Abraham. They had to look like men, because only men can actually break that delay from your life. They came as angels, but they appear as men, so that they can eat Abraham's food, drink his water, and then be able to give his season and timing to his expectation. Somebody needs to hear this. Somebody needs to hear this. Every time God promises you, he promises with the understanding of eternity, because that is where he lives. When God said, I will give you money, he has said it from the realms of eternity. And if you're not careful, eternity a day is like 1,000 years. So you don't live 1,000 years. You can die without seeing it. When God said, I will give you a child, he speaks from the realms of eternity. God does not understand Saturday. He does not know Monday. These are the classifications of men. Where he is, there is no night, there is no day. And to regulate season and timing, you need night and day. So when God promises to obey, to be free from the spirit of delay, he sends a man into your life who understands that you need to get married before menopause comes. Am I talking to somebody? Yes, sir. He sends a man into your life who understands that in life there is timing and there is season. Who understands in life is classified into the morning, the afternoon, and the evening. God brings a man into your life who knows there is a growing time, there is an ending time, and there should be a resting time. Can I talk to somebody here? Anytime God wants to break delay, he brings a man into your life who understands timing and season. That is why every time men have entered into people's condition and situation, their woes are timely, their woes are seasonal. That was why Elisha could say to the Shunammite woman, by this time next year, he had to put timing to expectation. You know what they said to Abraham? They said, Abraham, we don't care whether your wife laughs or doesn't laugh. By this time next year. That was why the prophet breaking delay and famine, he said, by this time tomorrow, men sent by God attach time and season to expectation. I don't care for how long you have waited for it. Look at my eyes. I don't care for how long you expected it. After today, I want to put time in. In the next 1 week, a miracle will surprise your life. Who am I talking to here? Who am I talking to here? I prophesy to somebody. In the next 40 days, this altar will hear your testimony. I don't know who I'm talking to here. Can I talk to another person? Before the end of this year, if I be a man of God, this will be the best year of your life. This will be the best year of your season. This will be the best year of Abu Sahalaba. Rapakata. Somebody lift up your hand and shout hallelujah. Say, I hear. Sit down, let me close this service. I feel an anointing here. I'm going to be praying for you shortly. And before I pray, I will bring you to a point of prayers where you will tell God, I am more than this. Am I talking to somebody here? And it's important sometimes that you appreciate the man that God has sent to your life so that your expectation can be given to you. I don't intend to blow my trumpet, but to the glory of God. Every time I speak, God honors it. I change men's life by the words of my mouth. If I lay hands on you, it's an auxiliary exercise. If I anoint you with oil, probably I am led. But as you sit down to hear me, something is lifting my spirit, packaged in my words and entering your life. Somebody say, I hear. Give me that amen like you believe. I'd like you to look at me here. Thank God for God's servant that just walking. Let's appreciate the grace of God upon his life. Let's do that. You're welcome. Amen. Lift up your hand, say no more delay. Say it again, say no more delay. Say like a minute, say no more delay. If your amen is louder, you will have a miracle. Say I hear.
I said that. I was in my office one of those days, and then, oh Lord, help me here. I was in my office one of the days, I was supervising my building, and then I just discovered that laborers were stealing my cement. So I decided to surprise them. By the following morning, I came very early. And I saw them actually packing the cement. So while we were talking, I saw a woman drop past, and then suddenly she reversed. Lord help me. And then she said, I am looking for the senior pastor here. I said, I'm the one. She said, no, she's not joking. She means the overall pastor. And I said, I am the one. She said, are you sure? I said, yes. She said, but you don't look it. I said, it's not in size. Am I talking to anybody here? And then she said to me, can we go to your office? I said, why not? We got to my office, and she told me a pathetic story that she is the only wife of a man that if she mentioned his name, I will know him. He's a politician, the speaker of Gombe State House of Assembly. I say, I know him. She said, that is my husband. I said, but you're a Muslim. She said, yes. I have been looking for a child for several years. Getting to 11, 12, 13, thereabout, if I can remember. She said, the reason why I want to see you is because we have gone everywhere. It didn't work. We imported enchanters from Chad. It didn't work. We came to America, saw our doctor. It didn't stay. We went to India. It didn't work. And I said to him, he loved me so much that this year I gave him the permission to marry another woman. For him to abhor with me as a Muslim for these several years, he has tried. But while I was passing, she said to me, something said the man here should pray for her. So when she said that, I was in my office and I took the olive oil on my table. And I said to her, kneel down. She knelt down. While I wanted to pray, the Spirit of God said to me, if you pray for her and she gets pregnant, who will dedicate the baby? To whose glory will the child come? I stopped my prayer. I said, madam, she said, yes. Do you know where you are? She said, church. Do you know who wants to pray for you? She said, pastor. I said, this is what God told me. You will have the child when I pray for you. Who will dedicate the baby? To whose glory will the child be? She said, pastor, I have looked for the child everywhere. If it comes by your prayer, I want to believe that you will come and pray for the child. But I will discuss it with my husband. So I took the oil on my table. I laid my hands on her and I was led to give her a little to drink. And then the power of God was strong upon her life. This God is a merciful God. The power of God was strong upon her life. And then she fell under the anointing. I was waiting for her to stand up. And when she did, smiles all over her face. And then, you know, I don't know, but she was really crying. So I didn't want to stress her much to ask what exactly she was experiencing. She thanked me and drove away, left her number on my table. When she got home that day, I didn't hear from her. In the midnight, I want to say this to jack up somebody's faith. In the midnight, I got a call on my phone. And when I picked it was a man's voice. The voice was rude. The voice was uncomplimentary and disrespectful. And I was angry. I said, who is that? And he mentioned his name. I am Honorable Farouk something. I said, Honorable. What is the problem? He said, my wife was in your office. I said, yes. What did you do to my wife? I said, like what? He said to me, since she came back, she has been stooling and she's on the bed weak. It looks like my wife wants to die. I want to know what you did to her. I said, I didn't do nothing. I prayed for her. And I said to him, give her the phone. Let me talk to her. I said, madam, her voice was faint. I said, what's the problem? She said, pastor, when you prayed for me in your office and gave me the anointing oil, I felt the power of God. And then the pain that used to hang around my waist that moves all over my body left in a second. I was so excited that I cried. When I drove from your office, I walked into a supermarket and I said to myself, if a small oil can make me heal, let me buy the biggest bottle. When I bought the bottle, pastor, I was driving home and I drank all. Am I talking to somebody here? Oh my God, let help me here. She said, I don't know how to use it. So I said to myself, if a small drop can heal the pains of several years, maybe if I drink all the bottle, I will get better. But when I get home, I said, there's stooling. I said, that is the reason for your stooling. The pain had gone. You have been healed. Get a doctor to stabilize your fluid. And that they did. Hear this. On the third month, I was in my office and I saw from the balcony. This man drove in with his wife and an elderly man following them behind. When they appeared in my office, it was their family doctor. And he said, pastor, I don't know how you did it, but I told them they can't get pregnant. She is about 3 months pregnant right now. Somebody wave your hand and shout hallelujah. She is about 3 months pregnant right now. And he said, I have come to find out what you did. I want to recommend some of my patients to your church. Am I talking to somebody here? Ladies and gentlemen, the man told me what I will not forget. He said, when the baby comes, I am a friend to the governor. All my friends that are Muslims, we watch you bless our baby. To the glory of God. Am I talking to somebody here?
Oh my God. I have been praying for people to get pregnant. They have gotten pregnant. That woman's case was unique. Number one, she was a Muslim. And when they came to thank me, my friend, I saw a pickup behind them. They have got some bags of rice. They have got some milk. They have got some wonderful gift. I say, all for who? They said, for you. And ladies and gentlemen, for every month the woman was pregnant, they were bringing me pickup of bag of rice, milk. Am I talking to somebody here? I felt like I stand in the days of the pregnancy. Hear this before you pray. Ladies and gentlemen, on the day of her delivery, doctor said they were going to cut her. They were going to do her CS. And a Muslim woman said to the doctor, I don't know how I got pregnant. And I know it's God. If he puts it there, the baby will come out by itself. Oh my God. It was becoming difficult. They said, madam, we need your husband to come and sign. The baby has to come out now, otherwise she will endanger your life. She said, I know I will deliver normally. Before the husband came, baby has jumped out. If God can break the delay of a Muslim woman, how much more you that pay your tithes? How much more you that comes to church? How much more you that have given your life to Christ? That devil is a liar. I speak to 50 of you here under the sound of my voice. Whatever represents delay is broken from your life. I don't like your amen. It's broken from your life. Let me hear that amen like a Christian. Lift up your right hand, say, no more delay. Say it again, say, no more delay. For the last time, say, no more delay. Say, I hear. Sit down. Get me an oil here. I want to touch somebody. Ladies and gentlemen, my intention tonight is to bring you to a point to know that you need to break that delay. Don't be deceived by Satan. There are many of you that are carrying a slogan. Thank you, sir. I need it in a container. Listen to me now in the next 10 minutes. Something will explode here. There are many of you that are sloganizing. I am waiting for God's time. Hold on the keyboard. You only tap the keyboard when the people are responding to my declaration. Let them hear what I have to say. Thank you, sir. There are many of you here that are sloganizing. I am waiting for God's time. God has no time and don't wait for any. It is a language the devil uses to tie us down. What do you understand by God's time when there is no time? He doesn't live in time. Time is the day you choose and determine to have that which you so desire. Am I talking to somebody here? Are you aware that Jesus followed the mother to a wedding and the wine was finished? When Mary came to him and said, sir, I know you can perform miracles here. Their wine is finished. Jesus said, my time has not come. Mary knows that there is no time where God is concerned. She left Jesus and went to the disciples and said, whatever he tells you to do, do it. And time will become yours. Am I talking to somebody here? So actually, timing is when you are willing to do what is required, you will acquire what you desire. Am I talking to somebody here? Oh Lord, help me to talk to somebody. Timing is when you are willing to do what is required, you will acquire what you desire. If blind Bartimaeus had waited for God's time, he would have died a blind man. Because Jesus was passing by, he was not in the program and agenda. That was why when he finally got Jesus' attention, they had to ask him, what do you want? If the man was in the menu, Jesus would have known his expectation. He cried and stopped the master. If Hannah had waited for God's time, she would have died a barren woman. She went to the temple that day and said, Lord, I need it now. Ladies and gentlemen, if Jacob had waited for timing, the angel would have gone when the day broke. He held the angel. He said, I will not let you go except you. irragadable. Am I talking to somebody here? So it's important to understand that timing is when you choose to get your miracle. Right from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of God suffered violence, and only the violence are taken back. And that is what I want you to do tonight. Take it by force. There is nothing you want that God has not provided. Search your scriptures. Every promises of God are in the past tense. Pastor, I'm waiting for God to heal me. Shut up. You have been healed. Pastor, I'm waiting for God to prosper me. Shut up. You have been prospered. I'm the Boshapai. Pastor, I am waiting for God to bring my husband. Stop that. The man is somewhere in the realms of the spirit. The man is somewhere. Am I talking to somebody here? Because God has given unto us all things that pertains to life and godliness. And so it is time to stand up and take your portion. I pray for you. If I be a man of God tonight, you will take what belongs to you. You will take what belongs to you. You will take what belongs to you. If your amen is louder, receive it now. Brother, say I hear. Say I hear. Say I hear, hear, hear. Sit down, let me conclude. The reason why you must not allow delay is because where there is delay, you get embarrassed. In the realm where we live, the beauty of a thing is in the time in which it's accomplished. He make it. Hear this. Am I blessing somebody here? Am I talking to anybody here? Is something entering your body? The beauty of a thing is not in the achievement and accomplishment. It is in the time in which it's accomplished. A girl in my state, Gombe State, became a full-fledged surgeon at 21. For some of you that are Nigerians, there's what they call NYC. It's a paramilitary service when you graduate from the university. When she served in my state, Gombe State, at 21, a full-fledged surgeon, the governor gave her an award, gave her an official car, and gave her a job in the government house with a crazy salary figure. At 21, she was the pride of the state. Is she the only surgeon? No, sir. Why was her own so spectacular? Timing. What will it take you? Why will you enjoy prosperity at the age of 70? How long do you want to live? Am I talking to somebody here? Oh my God. Am I talking to anybody here? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That is why it is not the proof. It's not the preaching of impatience. Somebody say, Pastor, they just got to be patient. I say, what do you understand by patient? Don't allow the secular world define for us spiritual terminology. Patient is waiting while the process is working. There is no man in your life. You are not in any reasonable relationship. And you say, I'm waiting to be married. That is not waiting. That is wasting. You only wait when there is a man. Am I talking to somebody here? Brata Costa Pai. Hello? So when nobody is in your life, then you can't tell me you're waiting to be married. You need to pray somebody into your life. And then when the person enters, then you can say, we are waiting to be married. Because a process is on. So you must deal with the spirit of delay. Otherwise, you get embarrassed. You will achieve at a very late time. What does it take to be married? I went to a wedding. Lord, help me here. And then a friend invited me. It was his best childhood friend that was getting married. At the age of 58, the woman was the one getting married. And I said, this is a wonderful wedding, but at the wrong time. Am I talking to somebody here? There are many of you that don't know that the time that you should have gotten your miracle passed. What you need is what I call restoration. The days that you should have been married went by. The days that you should have prospered went by for the years that the canker worms have eaten and the caterpillars have devoured. I will restore. I will restore. I will restore. Let me hear that amen like a thunder. Bakatosta. Say, I hear.
When I was coming to America for the first time a couple of months ago, there was this elderly woman. I don't know who sent her an invitation to come to America without somebody accompanying her. She was a burden. My son helped me. I was helping her. I said, Mama, you are alone? She said, you can see. If I'm not alone, will I ask you for help? Am I talking to somebody? Every fish will ask me, what did they write here? And I was explaining like a guide. And I said, Mama, do you really need to go to America? He said, I must enter there before I die. Am I talking to somebody here? Man, that is the wrong age to enter America. She had this eyeglass like a Coca-Cola bottle, very big. How will you see the beauty of America in that kind of an age? Somebody say, yeah. No wonder David prayed a prayer. He said, oh God, satisfy me early. I told the youth of my church, go and get married now. Nobody marries with money. We marry with mouth. Hello? Oh, yes. Cabrata Costa. Am I talking? Am I talking to anybody here? We marry with mouth. La kebosa palata. Regebosa. Hello? Go and find one and marry her with mouth. Mouth is what we marry with. If you have good mouth, she will pay your dowry. Then you can refund the money when you prosper. Somebody say, no more delay. Say it again, say, no more delay. Oh yes, you need to marry now. Teach me to number my days, that I will apply my heart to wisdom. Don't celebrate birthdays without achievement. Don't celebrate birthdays without accomplishment. Don't tell somebody, you know, I am 40 years now. Don't accumulate years and age without corresponding achievements. Teach us to number our days, that we might apply our heart to wisdom. You say to yourself, I'm 25 now, then it means at this age and this time, there are things I should accomplish. There are things I should achieve. Don't deceive yourself by looking very young. America has digital things to make a old man look young. But tell yourself the truth, at this age, there are things I should achieve. At this age, there are things I should accomplish. Can I talk to somebody here? I pray by the God I serve. Whatever you are due for, whatever you are qualified for, whatever has been your desire, receive them now. Who am I talking to here? Receive them now. Let me hear that amen 5 times. August, September, October, November, and December. Say, I hear. Lift up your hands. Say, oh God, no more delay. Say it again. Say, no more delay. Say it again. Say, no more delay. If you believe that, let your amen be louder. Sit down as I preach. In the next 1 minute, you're going to stand up. Pastor, I want to break delay. How? Number one, believe the man he has sent to you. This is not the night of analysis. This is not the night of calculating. I just want to believe enough is enough. Number two, be determined and have an expectation. What do you really want? Many of you don't even know what you want. As a matter of fact, I met a woman on a prayer line. I said, God wants to bless you. I was led. I said, tell me, what do you want God to do for you? She said, you want to hear it? I said, yes. She came by my hair. She said, horse. I said, horse? You want to play polo? She said, no. Horse. I said, what are you talking about? Is that English? Say yes. Husband. Am I talking to somebody? Oh my God. Mbola Barataha. If I ask you now, what is your expectation? What will you say? What are you believing God for? Otherwise, this service is not for you. If you have got an expectation in your heart, then God send me to you. I pray. Before August is over, somebody will enter his next level. Do I have a believer in the house? Do I have a Christian in the house? I'm a man of God. For some of you, in the next 40 days, this altar will hear your testimony. If your amen is louder, you are the one I'm talking about. If your amen is louder, you are the one I'm talking about. Say, I hear. But what are your expectations? If I say pray,
for you this year. That is why we are here, for God to do for us what we cannot do for ourselves. That is the essence of this service. The pastor does not just feel like bringing somebody from Africa. It's not about feeling. The pastor does not just want to have some wonderful meeting, make you feel good, massage your emotion, get you happy, and then the program ends and your problem continues. No, sir. We are here as agents of divine intervention. Am I talking to somebody here? We are here to bring you supernatural help. We are here to make sure that what your qualification couldn't do for you, what your connection couldn't do for you, what your position could not do for you, you will believe God. And it shall be done in your life. It shall be done in your life. It shall be done in your life. If your amen is louder, receive it now. Blackata. Somebody say, I hear. Somebody say, I hear. Slap your neighbor, say, what are your expectations? For the expectation of the righteous shall not be cut off. If you have no one, get it ready tonight. That is why this meeting is just starting. Because of the strongness of your desire. You're going to come every night. You're going to come every day. And stay with God. And graduate with your expectation. This is a weekend with Jehovah. I'm not talking to somebody here. I don't care who told you what. But with the Lord, all things are possible. Have an expectation. Voice your expectation. When Israel stood up, they said to themselves, enough of the slavery, enough of the begging, enough of the oppression and bondage. Lord, we want to come out now. Are you not surprised that until they stood up, before God actually stood up, when they cried, he said to Moses, I have heard their cry. I know their pain. I can see their sorrow. Somebody needs to cry out. Somebody needs to pray out. Somebody needs to shout. If you are the one, let me hear that amen like a thunder. Say, I hear. Say, I hear. I was preaching in Abuja in Christ Victorious Church. My God, they were ending their fasting, and there were these sisters that were bringing me food. Everywhere I go to preach, I pray for three categories of people: those that drive me around by the pastor's instruction, those that bring me food, I do that a lot, and then I pray for people that sometimes obey God in one direction or the other. So on the last day of my preaching, I said to her, what do you want God to do for you? I saw a woman that had a ready answer. My God, my God. She said to me, Pastor, I want to be married. I said, that is not East God. The Lord will do it. She said, no, you didn't hear my prayer request. I want it before April ending. And we were talking by February ending. Am I talking to somebody here? She said, Pastor, I want to get settled. And I said, what do you mean? Ladies and gentlemen, she told me something I want to shock you with. She said, everywhere I have gone, people greet me as if I am married. They say, Madam, good evening, ma. How are your children and family? Am I talking to somebody here? And she said to me, Pastor, I look like it, but I am not it. When the spirit of delay is at work, you will look like it. You won't be it. You are doing offering, you are dancing a very big man's dance. I have a very big God, a big song. But when you drop the offering, it does not correspond with the song. Neither does it correspond with your size and shape. You look like it, but you are not it. There are some of you, when the service closes now, will think you are driving to your car. You're going to be waiting for General Boss. You look like somebody that has a car. There are some of you, as I'm talking to you now, you look like a married man. But ladies and gentlemen, not even a reasonable relationship. There are some of you, as I'm talking to you now, you look like somebody reasonably working. You have not even finished high school. She said, Pastor, I look like it, but I am not it. And I said, that is why I came. To make your look correspond with your expectation. Am I talking to somebody? She said, Pastor, I want to be settled. And I want it before April. I knew the kind of prayer that came out of my heart. It was simple but powerful. There are men, God is committed to the words of their mouth. I said to have the Lord grant you the desires of your heart now. I prayed that prayer. God was my witness. I was in Kubwa, for some of you that know Nigeria. It's a state, a suburb in Abuja. I was staying in Ignobis Hotel at the top floor. So while she was coming down, a man was hanging by the reception.
Whatever I was doing, nobody knew. But when she passed, he lifted up his eyes. And then he saw her. He said, excuse me. Hello, please. Excuse me. She said, me? He said, yes. And he came close. He said, sorry for embarrassing you. But when I saw you pass, something said to me, you are my wife. She said, excuse me, please. He said, no, I'm sorry. But I just want to, I don't know. I just have to say this now. I came to this town to see my parents since December. I stay in London. I'm a practicing lawyer. I attend a church in London. I want to see your pastor in case you are confused. Ah, somebody prayed upstairs. I'm meeting a man downstairs. She said, I don't know what you are talking about. Am I talking to anybody here? Somebody say sharp, sharp. Talk to me now. Say sharp, sharp. Talk to me. Say sharp, sharp. Hey. After today, it will sharply enter somebody's life. She said, I don't know what you're talking about, but if you want to see my pastor, I can take you there. And then she took him to her pastor, Bishop Paul Ayegboje. And then he said to her, he said, do you know him? She said, yes. I don't know, but Apostle Paul prayed for me upstairs. The man became serious downstairs, and I felt you should see him. By the time they interviewed the man, Bishop Paul was so impressed. Born again Christian, knows why he came to Nigeria. He told God he wants to marry from Nigeria. His parents were in Kubwa. He had a Christmas with them, and he told God, I'm not going back until you give me who I want to settle with. Right there, they put a call to London. Bishop Maitu Ashimolowo picked it. Do you know this young man? He said, what is his name? They mentioned, he said, that is my son. I know why he's in Nigeria. He's one of the executives of our youth fellowship. Please accord him whatever assistance. Wow. His pastor knows him. As soon as the girl heard that, the pastor asked her, are you really interested in him? She said, well, I think so. But the problem is going to be my parents, because the man seems to be in a hurry. Pastor said, no, I will talk to your father. For me to have confirmed his personality and identity, I will make it work. The man put a call through to the girl's father. I would like to see you in my office. Sir, what is the reason? Your daughter is here with the man, and I think we need to discuss it. I know who the man is. The father of the girl said, well, in our place, we don't do that. You have to come to our house. We have a place you have to go and see the elders if you really need our daughter. But I'm talking to my wife now. We will come and see you to explain our tradition. When he mentioned to the wife, somebody needs our daughter, and the person is in the pastor's office, the woman fled up. What kind of a thing is this? Pastor should know our tradition. In his office, we can't discuss our daughter's wedding. The husband said, cool down. Let's just go and see pastor. She went putting up a face. They appeared there. Pastor said, there's a young man here. He needs your daughter. He's from London, a practicing lawyer, member of Ashimolowo's church. He said, where? They said, London. She said, what are we doing here? Let's start the class. Somebody shout hallelujah. Who does not want to go to London for Mugo? He said, you people should have told me that from the house. Pastor, let's start the plan. But hear this before you pray. Boko Sapalita ha. Manda brato hisaha. Hear this before you pray. On the day of the wedding, I was opportune to be the guest speaker. And I saw a wedding I've not seen all my life. The groom danced into the hall. Everybody was charged and glamorous and colorful. When it was her time, music and her dancing step were not corresponding. Hear this, and then we pray shortly. Am I blessing somebody here? Am I talking to anybody here? And then when the music was going, her dancing step was different. And then she would dance and dance and then look right. You know, in Nigeria, there's what they call unto. She will dance and then look left, and then she will do some people like this. Am I talking to somebody here? She was just doing that all around. Then when she came and sat down with her long flowing gown, I said, what kind of a dance is that? She said, pastor, you won't understand. There are people who thought I will never be married. As I entered the hall, I saw them there. So while the music was going on, I didn't mind the music. I was singing my own in my heart. You thought I will not be married? Hallelujah. Rabakalebosha. Mamda brakatobia. You thought I will not be married? This is, am I talking to somebody here?
All of us are by. Are you aware that when there is a delay, people conclude on your life? I don't think he can ever be anything. I don't think she will ever get married. He's going to be in America and come home back with Ghana must go, Ghana must come. I'm not talking to somebody here. He can't finish that house in the village. It's only foundation. He's not going to go anywhere. And here and there, they just conclude on your life. She's past the age. No man will come for her. Friends, weeping might endure for a night. Joy comes in the morning time. My God, when the Lord shall turn again the captivity of Zion, we shall be like them that dream, and our mouth shall be filled with laughter. The hideous we see, and they shall say, their God has done great things for them. Wherefore we are glad. Hear my word to every man, every woman, boy and girl. After this service, your neighbors will hear your testimony. Your friends will see your miracle. Your colleague will touch your expectation. If you're the one I'm talking about, let me hear that amen like a thunder. I prophesy, whatever has been delayed in your life, if I be a man of God, after tonight, I release it in your direction. I release it in your direction. I release it in your direction. Lift up your hand and shall fire. Shake your body and shall fire. Lift your leg and shall fire. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey, Abagala, stand on your feet wherever you are. Say, Lord, no more delay. Say it again. Say it again. Say it again. Lift up your hands wherever you are. If you are sitting, I'd like you to stand. Except if you don't understand what I preached tonight. God told me, break their delay. The kind of prayer I want you to pray is to tell yourself, I am more than this. And hear me, whatever becomes your desired next level, prophetically, I will push you into it. Do you understand English in this church? Yourself, I am more than this. If you pray that well, it becomes my responsibility to prophetically and apostolically push you to that next level of your life. Some of you, your next level you know is prosperity. For some of you, your next level you know is marital settlement. For some of you, your next level you know is to finish that project. Some of you, your next level you know is healing. And some of you, your next level is to tell yourself the truth. At this age, I shouldn't be a sinner. At this age, I should be serving God. Am I talking to anybody here? If you pray that prayer well, then that is why I came. I am aware that there are certain things that brings delay. Demonic and satanic aggression. I know there are wicked men and women that probably delays your destiny. I don't care where they are. After today, fire will locate them. Who am I talking to? Fire will locate them. Any Pharaoh that say you will die in Egypt, that you cannot enter your Canaan, God will swallow that Pharaoh tonight. Amen. Who am I talking to? God will swallow that Pharaoh here tonight. Many of you are from African background, coming from villages where you have terrible men and terrible women. They know you are in America, but they have vowed that you will not touch the blessings of America. And then, Obo Shaparataha, here you are. You are not responsible. You are not prosperous. You are not stable. Nothing to achieve because somebody somewhere, back somewhere, is doing certain stuff by enchantment, by divination, by sorcery, monitoring your life to ensure that nothing works for you. I stand here today by the anointing of God upon my life. Wherever they are, Holy Ghost. Breteke da balata, amangre po shakalata. Lift up your hand, say, oh God, no more delay. Lift up your hand, say, oh God, no more delay. Are you ready to pray that prayer? Are you ready to pray that prayer? I don't want a psychedelic prayer here, please. I don't want an American system prayer here. Yes, Lord God, I know you are there. He has always been there. I'm going to talk to somebody here. You know the kind of prayer I want to pray? Move those mountains out of your life. He that say to this mountain, be thou removed. You know the kind of prayer I want you to pray? The prayer of Caleb, give me this mountain. Give me my inheritance. Give me my destiny. I need it now.
If you pray that way, then you can be sure that testimony is coming for you. Lift up your hands wherever you are. Am I talking to anybody here? In these 3 minutes of prayer, please, for a second, be serious. I'd like you to pray the way they pray in my church. Clap your hands. Tell yourself, are you ready? Radical, hell-shaking, God-moving prayer, answering prayer. Say, oh God, by the blood of Jesus, I have come before you today. I declare every delay in my life, in my destiny. Right now, I break that delay. Now. Clap your hands and pray that prayer. Every delay in my life, in my destiny, in my business, in my health. Oh God, no more delay. Lord, no more delay. I enter the next level of my life. Clap your hands and pray that. Kabash, rapakata, ekorabaziba. Clap your hands and pray. Whatever is delayed in my life, in my destiny, Lord, no more. Pray that prayer. Pray that prayer. Rabakata laha. Let me hear you pray. No more delay. No more delay. No more delay. Now I break it. Now I reject it. Now, Rabakata, clap your hands and pray. Let me hear you pray that prayer. No more. Lord, no more. Lord, no more. Rabakata. Ekabaradaha, ekabarataha, ebarada bakosh, ekamananda brash, ekalabarataha, ekobadikalaha, memde brash tapai, dakai, dakai, dakai. In the name of Jesus, let me hear that amen like a thunder. Let me hear that amen like a believe. Lift up your hands. I want to feel in my spirit that somebody is pulling something. I want to feel it. My friend, God only acts when you react. It's important to know this. Many of you say, I'm waiting for God. Shut up. God is waiting for you. That is why you have to react. If you don't react, the devil is a wicked devil. He will kill your Stephen. He will decapitate your James. He will arrest your Peter. Until you react, he will equally kill your Peter. Why was God sitting down when they killed Stephen? Where was the angel that brought Peter out when they were killing James? When they carried Peter, the church said, no, enough is. When they reacted, an angel left heaven to the prison, brought Peter out without the gate being opened. The question is, where was he when they were killing James? If you don't react, you will die a single person. It's not a prophecy, it's an advice. If you don't react, poverty will be your middle name. If you don't react, Satan will give you fever. From fever, it will become high fever. From high fever, it will become typhoid. From typhoid, you become Ebola fever. The devil is a bad devil. Am I talking to somebody here? If I had not gone to that mountain, I would have died a poor boy, poor preacher. That year, I will never forget. 2009. If you ask me what is my prayer point now, I will have to think twice. I am married. I finished giving birth to my children a long time. So blessed that I am not working for money. Money is working for me. I have institutions. I have an estate. Even if God come today, I can say, thank you, I have lived a good life. Because at my age, at 40, I look around, there is nothing else to pray for but for health. I am so blessed that my level of prayer has passed God, bless me. I am helping 400 widows every month. Husbands killed in the religious riot. Ran into Gombe from Meduguri, from Yobe, from Adamawa. I just said I want to do welfare for widows. Before I say Jesus is Lord, 300 appeared. And I said, if God has helped me, I want to help others. Amen. Am I talking to somebody here?
Break that delay. React. React. Otherwise, you will marry when you are very old.
And then, performance becomes a prayer point. Am I talking to anybody here? Oh, you are laughing. It's a serious matter. It's a serious matter. Let it happen. Talk to me. Let it happen. Talk to me. Let it happen. Talk to me. Let it happen. That is the last prayer you pray. React. Enough is.
Enough.
If he died to heal me, no more sickness in my body.
Amen.
If he became poor for me to become rich, his poverty will not be in vain. I must touch riches.
Amen.
I didn't come to America to come and look at the bridges. Am I talking to anybody here?
Amen.
I want to make a difference. Are you ready to pray this prayer now?
Yes.
I call it African prayer point.
Amen.
Lift up your hands. If there's any man anywhere that does not want to see me prosper, Holy Ghost.
Fire!
You are here. They are mocking you in Nigeria. Let's see how you come back. You will disappoint them. You will disappoint them. You will disappoint them. You will disappoint them. Lift up your hands for this last prayer. If I catch you not praying, that means you don't have expectation. We didn't leave our houses and jobs to come here. It's not for fun. If you don't have a testimony, what did we gather for? You have to pray. My stepmother told my mother when they were giving birth out of competition, my mother won. Because my father is a polygamous man. My mother will born this year. My stepmother will born next year. Before he said Jesus is Lord, we were 20. And then my mother had 15. She, my stepmother, had a lot of miscarriages. So she would look at my mother. It's not to give birth to children. It's to give birth to useful ones. Am I talking to somebody here? And God brought a useful one from the family. Say, here. You will disappoint them. I don't like your amen. You will disappoint them.
Amen.
I don't like your amen. You will disappoint them.
Amen.
They thought you will not be married.
Untor.
They thought you will not build that house.
Untor.
They thought you will die with that sickness.
Untor.
They thought you will return back from America begging.
Untor. Here.
Lift up your right hand. Mahanda Bakaista. Say, oh God, every delay. No more. Now. Clap your hands and pray that prayer. Every delay in my life, in my family, in my career, in my health. Clap your hands and pray. No more. Ragabaha. Rapataha. Regebokosaha. Pray that prayer. Lambahada. Every delay by the power of God. Manda, I release you to your next level. Medeboshaha. Pray that prayer like a believer. Over my life, over my destiny, no more delay. Whatever I am destined for, whatever I am born for, Ebozahala Barata, Mamde Broshtakai, whatever constitute delay in my life. Brataha. In the name of Jesus, lift up your hands wherever you are. Give me a little volume there. Lift up your hands wherever you are. Ladies and gentlemen, hear this. I don't care whether there is a man that is responsible for the delay of your life. I don't care whether it runs through your family lineage that nobody gets rich, that nobody gets blessed, that nobody gets prosperous. I don't care whether there is a spirit that will not allow you enter your next level. I stand here today by the power of the word. I release you to your next level now. Whatever is responsible for where you are, your stagnation, your limitation, your delay, that power is broken from your life. That power is broken from your life. That power is broken from your life. Let me hear that amen like a thunder. Stretch your hands to the altar. Stretch your two hands. I stand on this exalted altar in agreement with the servant of this house. By the anointing upon my life, by the efficacy of the word I preach, whatever is your next level, be it marriage, be it children, be it prosperity, be it breakthrough, I declare, enter it now. Now, in the name of Jesus, I declare by the God I serve, because you are in America, I command your location to meet you here. I command your blessing to meet you here. I command your greatness to locate you here. In the name of Jesus. I speak to this land. I speak to her people. May they vomit your inheritance. May every day be a better day. May every month be a better month. Hear me and hear me well. Whatever you need to say is a good year. Lift up your hands. Stretch your hands here. He that confirmed the words of his servant and performed the counsel of his messenger. Whatever you need to say is a good year before December 31st. Receive them now. Bakata. Receive them now. Receive them now. Receive them now. Thank you, my Father. In the precious name of Jesus. Lift up your hands and begin to give him thanks. Lift up your hands and give him thanks. Baka liva. Manda brashta. No more delay. No more delay. No more delay. No more delay. Somebody say amen. Stretch your two hands here. Bakato ligaha. Le endo moshapai. I would like you to do me a favor as I'm led. You know what God told me? Whatever you desire, it will locate you here. By tomorrow, if the pastor gives me the privilege, I will be anointing every hand with oil. I will be touching every head with oil. Pastor, why? My hand must touch my desire. If you need to get pregnant, hear me. By the God I serve, it's one anointing God gave me. In the next 9 months, there must be a cry of a baby in your house. It's an anointing God gave me. If a Muslim woman can get pregnant, you have more right. You deserve the benefit of this salvation. I don't care how tired your husband is. If a virgin that needed not a child got pregnant, you have better reason to be pregnant. I'm going to talk to somebody here. I have that anointing. I have the anointing to change your financial status. Nobody can give you what he has not gotten. I am a blessed man. Can I talk to anybody here? Before December, strange financial flow will enter your hands. Say I hear. So tomorrow, by the grace of God, God permitting me, every hand I will touch with oil. Hear me, if I touch your hand and your hand does not touch something, I am not a man of God. I am not bluffing here. There is a God that is committed to my life. And hear this, I want to give it as a free instruction. If you can get an American flag, this land must favor you. Am I talking to anybody here? I am telling you what I am led in my spirit. Labrata, he said that we take you to a land that flows with milk and honey. You are not here by mistake. You are not here by accident. It's not a coincidence to be here. And for whatever God brought you for, it's beyond you. It's beyond you. There are some of you here, your being in America is the hope of an entire community. For being in America is the hope of an entire family. And the devil cannot keep you like this. The devil cannot keep you like this. Somebody say, I hear. Somebody say, I hear. Every hand, ladies and gentlemen, if you know any member of this church that is not here, beg them to come tomorrow. All days are not the same. Every day has its anointing. God told me to command this city to vomit your portion. I'm the booster. The true test of a man of God is not in his eloquence and fluence, it's in the fulfillment of the words of his mouth. That is how you know a man of God. It's not in good clothes like this. It's not in good English. It's in the goose that enter your hand. Am I talking to somebody here? And you must promise me one thing. Don't keep your testimony when it happens. So that I don't look like a liar. Am I talking to anybody here? Say, I receive it. Talk to me, say, I receive it. Talk to me, say, I receive it. Let me go with Shapara. So get your hands ready. If I were you, I will take a little fast. Whether it's breakfast, skip it, or you skip lunch. But tomorrow, something has got to happen. Something has got to happen. There are some of you, you are looking so comfortable. I'm already consigned for you. I know you are more than this. Am I talking to somebody here? This is not your level. Give me that flag. Something will enter you in this country. Stretch your hands. I want to pray my prayer now. So tomorrow, please don't come alone. If you have a neighbor, tell him one northern preacher is in the U.S. is in our church. They will thank you for bringing them for life. It's not an exaggeration. Get a friend. Get a neighbor. Get a colleague. Bring them to service tomorrow. I promise you, they will thank you till they die. Because what God cannot get through you, he cannot get to you. Be ready to share. Tell God, what you are doing in my church is not me alone. I want to get a friend into it. To come alone tomorrow is not to understand this instruction. When we know what is obtainable, we persuade men. Pay their transport if you care. Visit them, drive them through. This service is not only for your church. God wants to use you. Amen. Say, I hear. Braka talibokosha. I'm the braka talibaha. And everybody will be anointed. For some of you, I will give you days. Some of you, I will give you time. You will see it. The essence of power is to create change. Amen. Feel free, clap. You don't pay for it. Somebody say, I hear. Were you blessed here tonight? Say, no more delay. Stretch your two hands. Kabraka taligados. Me enter. Labanta kush. Breka tolibaha. Hear this. Look up here. When you are coming tomorrow, there is one major thing that you can do to break delay. Read that story when you get home. 430. God sent Moses to the place. Power did not make Pharaoh change his mind. Water became blood. Pharaoh was hardened. Grasshopper, mosquitoes. Pharaoh was hardened. But ladies and gentlemen, the night that every family took a sacrifice was the last night they spent in Egypt. The last night that every family slaughtered something. Let's go back to scriptures. It was the last night they spent in Egypt. Tomorrow when you are coming, I don't intend to persuade. I don't intend to cajole. I am too big for that. But if you are coming tomorrow, I'd like you to dare a sacrifice. Put it in an envelope and tell God, no more delay. It will facilitate and accelerate that which you so desire. Hannah prayed. There was no Samuel, no child. Every year going to Shiloh. One day she prayed by revelation. Give me a child. I will give him back. That was it. Delay was broken overnight. Because she vowed to give God back.
that which he intend to do for her. When you are coming tomorrow, and I mean everybody, listen to your spirit, open your heart. Because sometimes when we say, how many of you wants to give 500? Sometimes we call you and you undergive. Sometimes you overgive. But when God tells you to give, only God can tell you to give Isaac. No pastor can ask that. Am I to somebody here? If you're a member of a church, the pastor said, bring that your only son. Will you come to service next Sunday? There are dimensions of giving only him can tell you. And that is what I want you to do tomorrow. This is the beginning of the meeting. Let it not be by pressure. Let it be by conviction and perception. Lord, I want to empty my account. It's him that tell you. Lord, I want to give you that 500. It's him. Lord, I want to give you this $100. It's him. Lord, I want to give you that $200. It's him. Let it be a revelation from him. And then you will know you met him. But don't meet him empty-handed tomorrow. I beg you. That will be the final straw that will break this delay. Somebody say, I hear. Somebody say, I hear. Somebody say, I hear. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And when you come to a point where you cannot give a sacrifice, you don't know God. You don't know God. You don't know God. As you sleep tonight, he told me I should not be specific about any figure. He wants to deal with you by himself. He told me that. If I feel like doing it, I will do it and people will come out. But when he tells me, don't mention it, I will tell them what to give me. And I know he will. Stretch your two hands. Bakatai. Get an envelope. Let it not be that of the church. Write your name on it. No, not name. Write on it, no more delay. Say it again. 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 No more delay. Stretch your two hands. Father, I thank you. If I have spoken by you, everyone that sleeps tonight, let their heart be open. Let their life move forward. I say to them, like Mary said to the disciples, whatever he tells them to do, whatever he tells you to do tonight, may you do it. In your doing it, may you enter your next level. In the precious name of Jesus. I declare that your hand will carry your wedding ring. Amen. I stand on this altar from which God's word has come. If I am a servant, your hand will build that project. Your hands, Kaprata, will touch that level of prosperity. Your hand will not go back to tablets and injections. Your hand will carry your heart desire. Let me hear that amen like a thunder. Father, I thank you. Lift up your two hands and give him thanks. No more delay. No more delay. No more delay. Pastor, I want to do this. Stretch your two hands, everybody. If you are here, give me this opportunity to deliver myself from somebody's blood. I may be the last preacher you may see. Salvation, when it comes, is the day you have to receive it. On the day you die, I don't want God to say to me, Odola, you preach. And his blood is required. Because you did not give him an opportunity to meet me. You have waited for too long. Give your life now. Give your life now. Wherever you are, as every hand is stretched out to God for supernatural help, you want to say, Apostle Paul Odola, it's time to come to my God. It's time to give my life. I will pray for you without shame. And the God whom I serve will write your name in a book of life. And your desires will be granted. Amen. Let me hear that amen like a believer. Amen. Wherever you are, please, I'd like you to come. I will touch your head with oil. Pastor, I want to give my life to Christ. I don't know why I came tonight, but now I know. I want to surrender all. Please come. I don't care whether it's just one person. My mission is accomplished. Everybody lift up your hands as we begin to give him thanks. My end of bros to have. Wherever you are, Pastor, I want to give my life to Christ. I'd like you to come. I will pray for you. I will pray with you. I believe there is such person here. Thank you, Jesus. Church, this is wonderful. This is wonderful. This is wonderful. This is wonderful. This is beautiful. 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 Lord, I give you my heart. Do you know the song? I give you my soul. I
you. Alone, every. Please kneel down. Every moment I'm away, Lord, have your way. Amen. Choir, go back. Kneel down. Father, look at your daughter. Church, stretch your hand towards this beloved daughter of God. May today be the day you will not forget in your life. Whatever you came to planet Earth for, the purpose for which God battered you, may it be established in your life. I pray for you today that by this encounter, every other delay is broken from your life. In the precious name of Jesus. Father, our sins are forgiven. By this step of faith, let the power of sin be broken from this life. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Repeat after me. Say, Lord, I give you my life. Accept me as I am. Wash me with your blood. And I vow to follow you for the rest of my life. And do for me what I cannot do for myself. In Jesus' name. May the Lord do for you what you can do for yourself. By the virtue of what he will do for you, may your life becomes a spectacle that will bring others to Jesus. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
And everybody say amen.
Amen.
Give the Lord a clap of him wherever you are. Is that the best you can give God? Let's celebrate him. Let's celebrate him. Let's celebrate him. Let's celebrate him. Amen and amen. Help me look for 5 people. Slap them. Say no more delay. Tell 5 of them. Say no more delay. Say it again. Say no more delay. Look for 5 persons, professor. No more delay.